once again, dear Transformers animated fans. Today we'll be doing a review of the Voyager class Bulkhead. Yeah, really good vehicle mode. It's a SWAT vehicle, they call it. It's a, like a big army truck. Really, really cool looking. I like this vehicle mode because it really sticks together. It doesn't flop around if you shake it. It's really big, really sturdy, a bit heavy, and it's pretty big. It has a good scale compared to the other ones. Not such a good scale in robot mode, which I'll get to later, but oh well. The majority of it is this army, like, camouflage-type forest green. And then we've got spray-painted black here, around there, and on the, I guess I'll call that the windshield. It's really thin for a windshield. I don't see how anyone can see out of it. Yeah, on the front, gold metallic lights spray-painted there. This maroon, like, pink spray-painted metallic, and the tannish like silver in this grill here. Same with the hubcaps on the wheels. And yeah, look, then there's these white stars right here to symbolize that it's an army vehicle. And the lights here are just spray printed red. They don't flash, they don't make noises. They're just both red though, not red and blue like they are in the show. But I guess that's fine. And yeah, it's got six wheels. It's a really big vehicle. And yeah, like I said, it's show accurate, pretty much. It doesn't have any spring-loaded missiles or anything, because he doesn't shoot anything out of him in the show when he's in his vehicle mode. Doesn't matter. Now, for my rating, I will give this a 10 out of 10, because there's nothing wrong with it. I really like it. I think it's really cool-looking. Yeah, nothing wrong with it. Now I will transform him into his robot mode. What you're going to want to do... I do this first. You can either do these things or these. I'm going to take these because it's a little harder. It's kind of hard to do sometimes. They're kind of stuck in there pretty good. They stick together good. Pull it out, and as you can see, that's how it's put together. It will flip down like that, and then you just bend that thing in. Do the same with the other one. And then, this is pretty interesting, just like in the show, the back doors... It just flips down. They both flip down together. You can see those are his arms. And then this is really cool. You try to get these apart. Do that, I guess. If you push this down like that way, see how they're put together, just like these things. Watch what happens to his arm. Yeah, it's like automorph. It just flips forward like that, and then push it down all the way like that, and then. Put that down. Do the same with the other one. There goes his arm. And then do that. Now, let's get to the front of the vehicle. Just put the arms however you want, so making sure they won't get out of the way. Look down here. Oh, well, actually, let's push them all the way in so that peg goes into the hole so they won't flop down and get in the way. Down here, take the wheels and... push it out like that, and it's going to swerve in at an angle. Everything swerves in at an angle with this figure. These, and these, and these. Do the same with the other one, and then pull his feet down. His whole legs, his really, really short legs. You can see this is his belly and his chest. This is his hips, and just push that forward. Clicks in place, and it makes his head turn with the automorph, but it doesn't make it turn all the way, so you're just going to have to finish it on your own. There's his head. You can actually put his head down when he's in robot mode. And then this is here right now. Push that up and it clicks into place. And then just do whatever you want with his arms. Pretty much. And there you go. There's Voyager class Bulkhead from Transformers Animated. He's pretty nice. I really like this figure. His posability. Like, he is pretty big and bulky, and it's gonna limit his posability. His arms are ratcheted like that, and like this. They're kind of ratcheted, they just don't make noise. This arm here just swerves. This one is ratcheted. And the hands, or the arms right here, don't really look so accurate. They're round, but they've got this part sticking out like that. Like it's a teardrop shape, but oh well. He's got these pretty cool... elbow guards right there, and yeah, those are his shoulders right there with the white stars. Yeah, and I really don't like his legs. They're too short. which unfortunately gives him a bad scale. He's the shortest of all the... I think he's the shortest of all the Voyagers of Transformers Animated. I'm not sure. But he's shorter than all the other deluxe-class Autobots. I'll give you a scale comparison later. But anyways, the paint job's the same, pretty much. Silver Autobot logo engraved right below his chin. Head is... It's kind of fully poseable. It's kind of strange, though. It has, like, two hinges. I don't know if you can really see. It turns around there, and then down in there, you can't really see. See, it's turning with this part of his neck, but you can turn his head separate from his neck also. Let's put those back down. And yeah, let's, the other thing, these things are kind of sticking out here. Very not show accurate. That doesn't stick out in the show, but oh well. These things are here, though. They're sticking up here in the show, right behind his head, coming out of his back. And, yeah, everything else, the same colors, everything, except now we can see this silvery, brownish, silvery, grayish color right here on his arms and legs and on his fingers also. And you can kind of see some of that on his head, on his face, right above his mouth. Now for his gimmicks. He's got his wrecking ball in just one hand, his left hand. It looks like he's got it in this one, but that's just a decoration. It's just there. And to get that out, push the fingers apart. Get this thing down here. Let's see if this works. Shoot it out. It didn't come out all the way, probably because the string is getting pinched in there. So just pull it all the way out. That's how far it stretches. And there's his wrecking ball. Kind of show accurate, except it didn't have this part here. And it's all black. It's not green and black like it was supposed to be in the show. Push that back in. You can have him swing it around with his fingers out like that, or put them together. It swings pretty good. It stretches out far enough. And you can have him hold it like that in his other hand. Yeah, now this, I don't know if anyone's noticed this, if most reviewers have noticed this, or if they said anything about it on their reviews. But his other hand, I don't know why he does this. I don't see what the importance is of this. I'll stretch it out so you can see. If you put his arm out all the way like that, you see this black switch thing? Push it in this way and his arm will flip forward like that. Not very far. That's as far as it goes, but I don't know why it does that, like I said. Really weird. Yeah. I don't know what that's supposed to do, but oh well. There he is, Voyager class Bulkhead. I really like this figure. I really do. He's really sturdy. He's more poseable than he looks. His feet can't pose, but he's got ratcheted legs down here in pretty much every place also, except they swerve like that. He's more poseable than he looks. And, like, yeah, it is a pretty bulky figure. And, unfortunately, this is what I'm going to knock a point off for when I give my rating. He's not tall enough. He's a Voyager, but he is not tall enough. He's like the Voyager Lugnut. I don't have Lugnut yet, but I know that about him because I've read about it on the internet. I've seen pictures and seen other reviews. He's too short. I've got Deluxe Class Bumblebee. Look, can you see him? Look, he's taller than him. Yeah, I'm just going to do a comparison like that, because Bumblebee, he should be the shortest. He is the shortest in the show, I think. But this Bulkhead's too short, because his legs are too short. They could have made his legs a little taller, so he'd at least be taller than Bumblebee. But compared to Bumblebee in the show, he was like, I don't think you can see it. Can you see it? That tall. But oh well. Yeah, there's Bumblebee. Don't worry about him. Yeah, he's too short. The leader class is bigger. So you can get both of them. You could get him and the leader class. I'm going to get the leader class. The leader class Bulkhead is awesome. He's got more weapons, more gimmicks. However, he doesn't have a wrecking ball, I don't think. I'll have to see. But yeah, the leader class is really awesome. This one, I really like this figure, except the scale. So I'm going to give him a 9 out of 10. I think it's an awesome figure. Bulkhead's my favorite character in the show anyways. So, and I really like this figure. I'm glad I got it. But it'd be better if I had the leader class Bulkhead, because he's bigger and taller than the other Autobot figures. And that makes it look more realistic and more show accurate. And I really like the wrecking ball. I wish the leader class had the wrecking ball. But, oh well, what are you going to do about it? So, there you have it. Voyager class Bulkhead.